A pleasant day, class! Welcome to Horticulture Module for Grade 10. This focuses on Quarter 1, Week 2, Discussion. So let's get started. Let's begin with the care of seedlings and growing plants. In this lesson, you will learn the different diseases that may infect the nursery. Also, this may help you to prevent these diseases, take care of the nursery seedlings, and how you will grow the plants after they have been transferred from the nursery to their plant site. Listen attentively so you will understand this topic. First thing is the water and irrigation. Clean and sufficient water supply is vital among plants. In fact, they are made out of 90% water. If plants are grown in containers, it needs more attention and care, especially in watering. This is because containers limit the water availability compared to plants directly planted to the soil where we know water is present underneath. Grown roots that span over time has better chance of getting water necessary for growing plants. Watering should be done twice a day, early in the morning and late in the afternoon after 4 o'clock p.m. when the sun is not too hot. If this is not possible, then water once a day in the evening. During rainy season, watering may be done once or none at all. Avoid underwatering and overwatering. Use adequate amount of water, example 20 liters for 1,000 seedlings. There are three factors to consider in watering the seedlings. First, seedling age. Second, amount of sunlight. Third, soil type. For the seedling age, as the seedling develops, more water should supply as this helps the seedling grows, but gradually reduced when the developing seedling aged. For the amount of sunlight, as the seedlings are exposed under the sun, it can be dried easily, so it must need more water. But do not keep them in shady area for too long just to reduce the amount of water, simply because seedlings need sunlight as well. For the soil type, in the Philippine farming, sandy soil is actually discouraged because the type of this soil does not hold water and nutrients needed by the plants. The granules of sandy soil are loose, whereas clay soil is a typical planting soil because it holds firmly the plant to absorb nutrients present in the soil. Another way on how to take care of seedlings is weeding. Weeds are a threat to healthy seedlings' development. They compete with seedlings for nutrients, water, and light. Hence, they must be eradicated or controlled. With your hands or hand fork, gently pull out unwanted growth. This should be done whenever weeds are observed. Fertilizer. If the plant is showing signs of low nitrogen, then you could do one of the three things. First, make a shallow hole into the pot and add 4 to 5 granules of slow-released fertilizer. Slow-release fertilizer provide a steady supply of plant nutrient over an extended period of time. Second, apply worm castings directly to the surface and water well. Worm castings are an organic worm form of fertilizer produced from earthworms. Third, apply seaweed water solution to the leaves known as foliar spray, or soak in a seaweed solution once in every week until plants recover. Hardening and hardening off is the process of exposing transplant gradually to outdoor conditions. It is preparing developed seedling. Expose them to sunlight in order for them to adjust in a weather condition. It is giving the seedling time to adapt to the environment. This process is done 1. When the seedlings grow and reach the planting size, the shade should be removed to expose them more to sunlight. 2. Reduction in water intensity or quantity and frequency or how many times the watering should be done. 3. Before planting out, root pruning should be carried out frequently or make a rearrangement of pots to allow more adaptation to stress. 4. Good preparation for outplanting results in good field survival. Therefore, hardening should be done 2 to 3 weeks before planting out time. Another way of caring for plant is postponing planting. Plant your new plant as soon as it is practical. Better to postpone planting a few days if the weather is extremely hot. If you can't plant it right away, keep your new plants in a shady location and keep their roots moist. Another is root pruning. It is the trimming or cutting of roots to stimulate more growth, develop more thick and denser mass of roots, or to get rid of damaged or rotten roots, or to repot a root-bound plant into the same or smaller pot. This is done by adding water to seedlings properly before root pruning, using a sharp knife or wire or scissors to cut the long roots underneath the container. Uplift the containers to cut overgrown roots, and water the seedlings well after root pruning. This helps the plant withstand moisture stress. So now let's go to seedling protection. Seedlings are delicate and susceptible to attack by various pests and diseases as well as weather conditions. Such damages can seriously weaken or kill the seedlings. There are 4 factors that causes damages and disaster in the nursery. First, weather conditions. Second, human. Third, livestock and wild animals. Fourth, insects. Weather conditions. If rainy season, watering should be lessened in order to prevent plant drowning. Too much water may damage plant stem that causes weakening of their branches. Putting up shades during rainy season may also be a helpful tool in order to roof the plants. This roofing will avoid heavy water impact to our plants and also help from too much sunlight that may dry plants. Next is human. This is the stealing or intentional damaging of seedlings by human beings. Fencing and security are such options to overcome this. Third is livestock and wild animals. Livestock and wild animals browsing or grazing on seedlings. Fencing can offset this. While rodents such as field mice or rats frequently cause serious damage to seedlings in the nursery as well as in the field by eating them. To control this, cleaning the nursery helps to reduce their population. Next is the insects. In this module, we will identify certain type of insect that damage seedlings. First is the thrips. You can know if the plant was attacked by thrips if the plant leaves turn pale, splotchy, and silvery then die. Injured plants are twisted, discolored, and scarred. Use insecticide available in the market like Tripidae Plus. Next is green leaf hopper. This pest spread virus diseases like tungro, yellow dwarf, yellow orange leaf, and transitory yellowing diseases. It feeds by extracting plant sap with their needle-shaped mouth parts. Next is rice case worm. Rice case worm feeds on rice during the seedling and tillering stage of the crop. Its damage usually starts in flooded seedbed. Next is the paddy stem borer. It can destroy rice at any stage of the plant, from seedling to maturity. They feed upon tillers and cause dead hearts or drying of the central tillers during vegetative stage and cause white heads at the reproductive stage. Fifth is swarming caterpillar. It is a caterpillar that attacks rice, feed on rice by cutting off leaves and young seedlings at the plant's base. The larvae usually feed in the upper portion of the rice in cloudy days, while adult feeds, mate, and migrate at night at the base of the plant. Let's move on to common diseases. Although there are various diseases which attack seedlings in the nursery, damping off, powdery mildew, and wilt are described here since they are the most common fungal diseases in the country. First is damping off. It is a soil-borne fungal disease that affects seeds and new seedlings. It simply refers to rotting of stem, roots, and tissues at and below the soil surface. In most cases, infected plants will germinate and come up fine, but few days they become water-soaked and mushy, fall over at the base, and die. Damping off typically occurs when old seed is planted in cold, wet soil and is further increased by poor soil drainage. High humidity levels, rich potting soils, and planting too deeply will also encourage its growth. Next is powdery mildew. It is common on many plants and easily recognized. It is caused by a variety of closely related fungal species. Low soil moisture combined with high humidity levels at the plant surface favors this disease. Wilt. Wilt is a common symptom of plant disease resulting from water lost in leaves and stem. Affected parts lose their turgidity and droop. Let's proceed on the steps on how to take care of a seedling. It's the best time of the year when self-starting gardeners have sown their seeds indoors and are contemplating the next steps. Those tiny little sprouts have shown up and need the best care before they're planting them out. Thus, every gardener should take care for the seedlings to keep healthy and robust plants that will produce their faster and higher yields. These are a few of the things that every gardener should take into consideration. When seedlings have sprouted, give supplemental food until the cotyledon has completely emerged and several sets of true leaves are present. Seed starter mix are formulated with all the nutrients your new plants should need until they are planted outside. A soilless grown crop will benefit from fertilizer diluted by 1/4 once per week. Next, water your plants when the surface of the soil is dry to the touch. The exact time will depend on how warm the room is and how hot the light. The best temperature for optimum growth is between 70 and 80 degrees Fahrenheit or 21 to 26 degrees Celsius. Avoid exposing seedlings to temperatures below for more than a few hours and above 100 degrees Fahrenheit or 37 degrees Celsius, which will stunt root growth. Third, avoid overcrowding the plants where multiple seeds have sprouted in the same plant container. Successful care for seedlings once sprouted will take you on the road to transplanting. Plants grown in a peat cell should receive a new pot that will allow for future growth. You'll know when it is time if you can see roots out of the bottom of the cell. Spoon out the seedlings to avoid damaging the stem by lifting them. Use a good sterile soil again and water them well immediately. Last, apply hardening off before plants are introduced to the garden bed, while hardening them 2 weeks before planting outside. This will prevent stress that is associated with seedling failure after outdoor transplanting. After a couple of weeks, plant the seedling in a prepared seed bed and take care of them as they grow. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day! It is indeed a fruitful session for plantitos and plantitas. If you are new to my channel, don't forget to click the subscribe button and the notification bell for you to become updated in my upcoming videos. God bless everyone!